So there is this thing that people always tell online, that the switch statement is faster than the if statement, and that is simply false when talking about the C++ language. And this is not just a topic for debate. I want to prove it with this video. But let's start from the beginning, and trust me, I have things to blow your mind in this video, and you won't expect the conclusion either, so let's go. So the reason people say that switch statements are faster than if is simple. If you have some if statements like this, the code will just have to compare our value against all of the cases until it reaches the correct one. There are potentially a lot of comparisons. For the switch statement, however, the compiler can do tricks to avoid the comparisons altogether. As you can see here, basically, I am just using the variable input as an index in an array, which will get me the function that I want. So I don't make any comparisons, I just jump directly at the function that I want to execute. This is called a jump table. I of course oversimplify this code. I don't check for edge cases, but you can get the idea. And yes, I chose some simple numbers, but the compiler can also optimize weirder cases like these ones. And fact check me on this one, but I think that the switch case was specifically introduced to allow this kind of optimization. So how can the if statement be as fast as the switch statement given this code optimization? Just to be clear, it's way faster to jump into a table than to execute multiple if statements. You need to know one more thing about compilers, and that is that they are very smart. So to give you an idea, we have this function here. If you look at the assembly output of the compiler, we see this. So even if you don't know assembly, you probably understand that the compiler computed the for loop for you. And now the function just returns you the pre-computed result. But wait, it gets even cooler. Let's add a parameter to this function. Now the compiler can't pre-compute the result, so he has to run this for loop now, right? Wait, there is no loop in this code. So this jump instruction just returns if the input is 0. But there is no other jump instruction in this code, so no for loop. What's going on? Well, maybe you remember from school that there is a formula called the Gauss sum that allows you to calculate a sum like this one with a simple formula. Wait, don't tell me the compiler knows about the Gauss sum. It knows about the Gauss sum. So the compiler literally removed the for loop here by recognizing that it can be replaced with a mathematical formula. Here is the multiplication, and this shift right here is actually a division by 2. So I think I convinced you that compilers are very smart. And in fact, there are people who say that nowadays, compilers are way smarter and better at optimizing than humans are. And they are right in 99% of the cases. The compiler is still not perfect, and it fails to optimize perfectly some things. You can watch this video here for an example, but I think we can all agree that the compilers are extremely smart and good. Now, here is my problem. The same people who say that the compilers are extremely smart and way better than humans at optimizations also say that just by changing this if statement to a switch statement, you get a significant performance boost. So, a compiler that is so smart that it can literally find mathematical formulas in your code, and it is apparently almost impossible to beat by a human, can't recognize that this if statement can be optimized like a switch statement can. I know some very basic things about how compilers work, and this optimization doesn't really seem that hard to do in a computer. So I will prove that the compiler can actually optimize the if statement in the same way that it optimizes the switch statement. And I will be very clear about my statement, so you can disprove me if it happens that I am wrong. So I am talking about cases where the switch statement is equivalent to the if statement. Also, I am talking about modern C++ compilers with optimizations turned on. For older compilers, it was 100% true that the switch statement was faster, as you will later see in the video on some compiler update logs. But modern C++ compilers don't have this problem anymore. Also, I will test the commonly used C++ compilers, Clang, GCC, and MSBC. If you use, say, a custom C compiler that was built to compile on an embedded architecture, it is possible that the switch statements are also faster there. Also, this optimization probably also applies to other compiled languages, like Zig or Rust, which also uses LLVM, aka the same backend as the C++ Clang compiler. But it probably doesn't apply to just-in-time compiled languages like C#. So in C#, a switch might still be faster than if, but someone should also put that to the test. So again, keep in mind that I'm talking about modern common C++ compilers with optimizations turned on. But that is what most people use and care about. So let's start with a simple test. I'm using this website to compare two functions that call either an if statement or a switch statement many times. You can see that the two functions do the exact same thing. Now, it might seem wrong to call the run function on a performance test. What if the function gets some numbers to favor one function over the other? Well, fortunately, the run function is deterministic. So if I reseed it, I get the same random sequence of numbers every time. So by running the test, you will see that both functions are almost exactly the same speed. But the switch statement is just a few CPU cycles faster. So does this mean that I am stupid and wrong and that the switch statement is faster? No. First of all, by running the exact same code twice, you will never get the exact same speed. So if the difference is extremely small, that means that they are at the same speed. And I can prove it. The switch version is actually very slightly faster because it was called after the if version. And this does matter because after executing the first function, the instructions for the run function are in the cache of the CPU. So the second function will probably execute a little faster. So if I swap the order in which I execute the tests, the if statement will now execute slightly faster. But what if the gap is small because we don't do enough tests? So let's increase it to 5 million tests. And it is 5 million times how many times the benchmark executes this function over and over. And we still see that the functions execute at the same speed. And just to be extra sure, we can even look at the assembly code, and it looks almost identical. So it means that the compiler managed to optimize the if statement in exactly the same way as the switch statement. We are not done yet. We have to try more complex tests to really give the compiler a hard time. But first, check these things out. If we were to disable optimizations, the switch statement would actually be slightly faster, and you can clearly see the difference. But with optimizations, they are the same speed. Does this mean that you need to use the switch statement for the small boost in debug builds? Honestly, I don't really think so. Just use what looks more readable for your code. This is way more important than a 10% performance boost on probably not even a critical code path. Keep in mind that this was a very big if chain that I tested. I don't usually use switch statements because I don't actually like how they look, and I would be happy to know that this practice will not affect my performance. Now check this thing out. While doing research for this video, one friend from my Discord server actually found out the exact moment GCC introduced this optimization, and apparently it is in GCC 11, which was released in 2021. So it is quite recent. And look, I quote, "A series of conditional expressions that compare the same variable can be transformed into a switch statement if each of them contains a comparison expression." And the example that they give is really equivalent to a very nasty fault switch statement. So this is cool. And if we go back to an older version of GCC, the if version is clearly not optimized with a jump table, but it is somehow slightly faster. What? Well, this is because we have a few cases and because of how much we reuse the same ifs, helping the branch predictor. But it shows that optimizations are a very hard thing. Okay, so next, I tested with a very big test, with a ton of cases. Some of them are not in order, some of them are missing, and some values are just random. I did funky stuff like sometimes changing the counter of the for loop, and I also called rand in the middle of the test. And if that wasn't enough, I generated some code with a Python script to generate me more randomized cases. So this code has like 80 cases. I tried my best to confuse the compiler, and I still got the same speed. Now, depending on the order in which you do the tests, you will again get one test slightly faster than the other. But to make sure, we can look at the assembly, and it is still identical. And keep in mind, we have like 80 cases. Okay, I have one more, even bigger test. But check this out first. A switch statement can only do equal comparison. So I was wondering, what if I have a case that I have some consecutive values that can be compared by an if, like this? I honestly think this can mess with the compiler, and we could get a slower if. And I got a slightly faster switch in this case. Fortunately, the difference was always very small, and most importantly, we still get a jump table for the if. And this shows once again that optimizations are a difficult topic. Quick fun fact, MSBC sometimes fails to optimize both the switch and the if. And oh well, at least they are the same slow speed, so it doesn't disprove my theory. Now, the thing that confuses the compiler the most is having big abstractions, like big template classes. In this video, a lead Google engineer shows how even something as small as a unique pointer, compared to calling delete yourself, generated twice as many memory accesses. So a big difference. So in my last test, I will use STL objects, like vectors and strings. And would you look at that,
we still get the exact same speed. And yes, they both create jump tables.
But before drawing conclusions, there is only one more elephant to address in the room. There are many people who say that switching is faster than if. But they give simple examples, like, for example, low-level learning has this video and actually shows how switching is faster. I don't really know what to make of that. I also tested his code and it generated a jump table with the if statement. So maybe he didn't turn on optimizations, or maybe he had an older compiler. But I didn't make this video to criticize him. And I might be missing something, so low-level learning. If you're watching this video and you'd like us to investigate this if versus switch together, let me know. So for a modern C++ compiler, after a lot of tests, this is my conclusion. For most cases, and even cases with a ton of branches, switching is as fast as if, and especially for the simple examples that people usually give online. And I even found this GCC document confirming my theory.
And I found a case where the performance can shift by like 10% in favor of switch, but the important thing is that both the switch and the if will have a jump table, so the difference will never be substantial.
So next time someone tells you to use a switch statement in C++ because it will magically make your code faster, you can send him this video. And especially as a beginner, you should use what makes the code more readable, instead of caring about a 10% optimization boost.
That will not even happen 99% of cases.
That is not even in a critical code path. That, as you saw, is not as easy as replacing an if with a switch anyway. So check out another code busting video where I show why there is randomness in computers, or maybe this talk that I mentioned, and share this video. See you!